Hold up a second, you don't have to make the next Unity for it to be called a game engine. Something simple also counts. So I will talk about why it isn't hard to make a game engine, but also why you would want to do it in the first place. And also how I would recommend doing it. Think for a second what the best tip I could give you about making a game engine could be. Trust me, I have something even better that probably didn't even cross your mind, so stick till the end for that. A few years into my programming journey, there was this game called Pixel Dungeon that I used to play a lot and I'm still playing from time to time. And being confident in my programming skills, I thought I could implement something like that myself. All I needed to do basically was put some pixels on the screen, then I could draw the level and the characters using a fixed grid, and that was the game basically. I was really hyped for this project, but there was a big problem. I wasn't able to get any graphics library to work, so I couldn't draw anything on the screen. But then, someone showed me Unity for the first time, and it was really cool. It could do a ton of stuff for you, but at the same time, all I wanted to do was place a pixel on the screen, because I knew how to work my way up from there to make a game. So I didn't really want to mess with other new things, but of course, Unity doesn't work like that. So I had to learn how to use it, and I made a simple prototype, but I wasn't satisfied. I was spending around most of my time in the Unity editor, messing around with stuff or with other programs to paint maps and generate collision walls for them, and then I wasn't able to make the player the exact same size as the map tile size, and the project didn't feel satisfying at all. So I gave up on Unity and continued my quest in trying to get graphics to work. And I eventually did it and made this Terraria game with it. But this graphics obsession continued because I saw this Hobson video of a Minecraft clone in C++. This Terraria clone was just the beginning before moving properly to 3D. And I eventually learned OpenGL and made one Minecraft clone, and another one, and another one. And also, eventually, my own game engine. So then I hear you ask, why make your own game engine? Well, here is the thing, there are three kinds of people in this world. People that just want to make games, people that want to code and happen to find game dev related topics very interesting, and would also optionally like to make a game, and people that aren't in either of those categories, like web devs or normal people that don't like coding. But we aren't friends with those. And this debate of reinventing the wheel and making a game engine from scratch is stupid. If you just want to make a game and don't care about programming, then it doesn't make sense for you to make a game engine. Why would it? Maybe if you just want to make a very simple game and you already know a ton of programming, then there can be some advantages of making the game from scratch. This game was made from scratch, and I don't really think a game engine would have been of much help. I mean, the entire rendering pipeline is written from scratch to look retro like this. But if you watch my videos, you probably are into the second category, where you just like low-level programming. If so, you should probably subscribe. I mean, look at the name of my channel and the type of videos I make. But look, I know people will tell you that, oh, we will never make a game like this, or you will never make a good game, and you are wasting time. Let me tell you a secret, but promise you don't tell anyone. All these game engines were made by people and are still being updated by people. I see a lot of people use Godot right now, and they say it is way better than Unity or Unreal. Guess what? What if 10 years ago, the Godot creator thought, yeah, why reinvent the wheel when I have Unity or Unreal? You wouldn't have Godot today, would you? So, while if you just want to make a game fast, making a game engine isn't an option, some people just like coding interesting things from scratch. And trust me, you will learn a ton of things by making your game engine. And I promise, you will love just working on this project just because it is interesting. And next time you go to a game jam, you can make that game in your game engine. And when you will work in a game dev company, you will work on the game engine team instead of the gameplay team. And I'm pretty sure they do more interesting things there. And you are also paid better, so that's a win for me. Looking back on all of those haters, half of them probably never released a game anyway, but I actually have. This game was made from scratch, and this game that I'm currently working on is made in my framework. But what is a framework, and how does it differ from a game engine? Well, people usually think of game engines as programs where you have an editor and tools and entities and scripting, while a framework is more like a big library that gives you all the things you need to open a window and draw to it, maybe with the main function already written for you. So, should you make your own game engine or framework? Well, a game engine has a very big disadvantage that people don't talk about, and that is that it is trying to suit every possible game type. And I think it is obvious that one-fits-all solution isn't the best for anything. It is just good for most things, and not so good for others. I would rather spend some more time making special systems for my game, because that will save me time in the long run. Game engines usually use entity component systems and stuff like that, but I never used that in any of my games, because I didn't need it yet. But using a game engine we are kind of forced to use them. So I like frameworks more. Check my Minecraft clone, for example. Every system had to be done from scratch for it to work, like the chunk rendering or the multiplayer aspect. Or take my 2D game, it is totally different. So when I eventually made my own game engine, I made it more like a framework. It opens an engine window for you, and it has stuff like hot code reloading and input playback, and it has tools to easily add the 3D editor. But other than that, you write your own systems however you see fit in your game. So I recommend you start making a simple framework that can be something as simple as just taking all the libraries that you like and putting them all in a project, using CMake for example, and then writing the main function for it, opening the window, getting the input and the delta time. For that, I strongly recommend you watch this video, and then you have a framework that you can simply clone and start making a game in. My framework is in the description if you need inspiration. Or if you want, you can even make your own libraries for 2D and 3D stuff, instead of using pre-existing libraries, and add those to your framework, and make all your libraries interact nicely with one another. This is basically what I did. Then, you can also try to make a game engine. See, things aren't very hard if you take things step by step. Essentially, you just want to be able to have some entities, place them on the screen, and be able to edit some positions, and that's about it. It doesn't sound that hard if you say it like this, does it? But wait, I will give you two very important tips before you go. First, I see that many people, when they make a game engine, just blindly make it how other engines are. But look, in the case of Entity Component System, I didn't use that for my games, though it can definitely be useful for some types of games. But should it be there in every single game? I don't think so, but I see that people just get used to it and literally can make a game without it. And that can be good.
No! You should use an Entity Component System Factory Entity Pattern.
Shut it. I'm just making Snake.
These things are just tools, and you should use them if they are useful to you. They are not necessities. Another example is adding scripting to engines, and I'm very much against that. So scripting was added so that artists could write code and also to speed up the development process. But let's think about it. It is your engine, so you clearly know how to code. You can of course add a scripting language just for fun and for learning new things, but if you actually plan to do that, to actually use it, here are the downsides. Adding a scripting language means you need to integrate it with all your systems, so that means a ton of code. And if you use Lua, that isn't even strongly typed, so now you are making your code way less robust, way way harder to refactor, and way harder to maintain once it grows, and also slower. And people will say that you write your code faster using scripting languages, but hear me out. You like Python because you can manipulate your strings easily? What if, instead of adding an entire language to your engine, what if you implemented those useful features that are in Python and aren't in C++, so that you can also move fast in C++? And also, why not spend some time making some memory arenas and temporary allocators and a good asset system, so you don't have to worry about memory leaks problems? I don't think this will take more time than implementing bindings for all your engine features. So then, why not just write your entities in a different class for each entity? And you can even use polymorphism if you like or whatever. The main takeaway is to just try your own things and not over-abstract things. The most important tip though is to make a game with your engine, while making your engine. And the reasoning is very similar to the previous tip. You might think that you need an entity component system, or that you might need your entities to be made in a certain way, or to have some features. But bro, you are just guessing. Realistically, you don't have that much experience in making games. So what are the chances your guesses are correct? So, make a game while you are making the engine. And you will see that some systems need to be added in the engine, that some systems are useless, and that some systems need some changing around. Now again, I have videos about CMake and other advanced stuff, but if you have never even made your first C++ game yet, congrats for sticking till the end. I promise you that I'm here to help you with this channel. So subscribe for motivation and knowledge, and go watch this full guide, because I can get you to your first C++ game today with it. See you there!